have always defended this championship the way a true champion would. Now, I tell you what, Sting, if you've got any guts at all, you think that you deserve this United States Heavyweight Championship, why don't you just make an appearance every now and then? You know, I've stood in rings all across the country, everybody chanting, Stinger, Stinger. And where were you? You were in the dressing room sucking down a beer, celebrating your victory over a nobody. Well, let me tell you what, son. This championship is something I am going to hold on to because you are not capable of taking it. You're inept. You're not capable. So, James.
He'll never show up because Sting likes to stand out here, woo, and beat his chest and howl to an empty ring when there's nobody in here to face a challenge. He can strut his thing around and look cocky and be sassy because the ring is empty. But when the champion is standing here with the belt, we don't see him then. He's out behind the building howling to an empty parking lot. Sting, you're electrifying. You're great. You got the people behind you. But you're just a big empty bag of winners, Morgan. Holy mess. Look out.
Television's most exciting hour. Bob Caudle here along with Jim Ross, and we got a great hour for you this weekend. Jim, by the way, I've been getting a lot of questions, and I know you have too, about the condition of Jimmy Garvin. We know that Jimmy's mentally ready to get back in the ring, that he's anxious, that he wants to get in. But what about his physical condition?
Well, Bob, his physical condition is that he is still in a cast. He's taking his situation day to day. I know he's having daily visits with his specialist. He wants to get back in the ring, but physically, it's a day-to-day proposition. We're certainly going to keep our eye on it.
Fans, talking about this hour, Jim, I went back to the locker room a few minutes ago. I saw the biggest, most bizarre individual back there. Matter of fact, he was so bizarre, I turned right around and went out. I mean, that's something.
The man Bob's talking about, ladies and gentlemen, is 396-pound Bam Bam Bigelow, who will make his NWA debut right here on our program today.
And fans, that's just the beginning. Jim Cornette's going to be here. We're going to see his segment, Louisville Slugger. Jim always has something very interesting in that segment, too, Jim.
Jim Cornette back with the Louisville Slugger interview segment. And this week, his guest will be Sir Oliver Humperdinck and Bam Bam Bigelow. And by the way, we're going to see Bigelow in the ring here as well in the hour.
All right, and talking about that also, in addition to that, we're going to see the Russian Assassins, number one and two. Dr. Death, C. Williams, is going to be here. What about this youngster, Sting? He's also going to be here during this hour.
Certainly is. Plus, we want to give the fans an update. We know that Kevin Sullivan is interested in adding to the Varsity Club, and James J. Dillon also interesting in the adding to the Four Horsemen. We'll talk about that in the next 60 minutes. But right now, let's go to Tony Schiavone with the heavyweight champion of the world.
Thank you very much, Jim Ross. Bob Caudle, we are with the world heavyweight champion. As you know, the world champion, the U.S. champion, Barry Windham, together as members of the Four Horsemen. And now, when you talk about the total package, Lex Luger, he has a friend of his own.
First of all, you talk about Barry Windham and Ric Flair. You clearly are talking about the two best wrestlers in the world today. Bottom line, Barry Windham, Ric Flair, James Dillon, that is a dynasty unto its own. Nothing else makes it go. We are it. I am your World's Heavyweight Champion, Barry Windham, the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, and together we represent the elite and the greatest sport in the world. Now, Sting, my friend, you have made the mistake of walking that aisle and sticking your nose in my business once again. Think back, Sting. Last time you got my business, you got hurt. You paid the price. Luger and Ric Flair have got their own thing. Stay out of it. But, pal, if you want to get with Luger, you want a tag team match, you want a hot building on a hot night anywhere in the world, put it on a contract, because Barry Windham, Ric Flair, the Four Horsemen, James Dillon, we are the dynasty in this sport. And as I've said before, whether you like it or you don't like it, learn to love it. Woo! Because it is the best thing going today.
Woo! The world champion, the Nature Boy. Let's go back to the ring. It's Sting, as we're going to watch Sting go to work in the ring now as he takes on Larry Stevens in this match. And Sting, Jim, as we say, every wrestler, everybody that he wrestles, everybody that watches him, even the ones that have been in the wrestling profession and pros for a long, long time, are extremely impressed with all the tools that this young man has.
He certainly has a complete set of tools, no doubt about that. And he is hot on the trail for the United States Heavyweight Championship, currently held by Barry Windham. But he's also a man that, with Lex Luger, we all know, won the Crockett Cup. And if Luger and Flair were getting tag team action, I got to think that Sting and Luger could give them all they can handle.
And what a match that would be. When you get four men like that in the ring, it would be something fantastic. Already, Sting has got the Scorpion Deathlock locked in on Larry Stevens. And that's going to be it right there, Jim.
He's a phenomenal athlete, and I'm going to be talking with him in just a few moments, Bob. Ladies and gentlemen, he's electrified crowds all across the country. The Stinger is the number one contender for the United States Championship. But also, there is talk of the Stinger and Lex Luger joining forces against James J. Dillon's Ric Flair and Barry Windham. What's your comments on that situation?
Well, I figure if the Total Package and the Stinger are in the ring together against Barry Windham and Ric Flair, with, I think they're running out of horsemen to run in and cheat, which is the only way they've ever won. Cheat, 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 cheat. No more cheating now, because it's going to be 2-on-2. And James J. Dillon, you better have a very, very incredible miracle up your sleeve. If you don't, you better drink a lot of champagne and be drunk, because you're not going to like the sight that you see.
And after this, I'm out. He's scouting Dr. Death Steve Williams, a man that certainly knows about athletic competition, amateur and professional. There's Dr. Death with a half Nelson on the Nightmare. But Kevin Sullivan is taking a lot of notes here. And we've said that there's two sides of Kevin Sullivan. One is a relatively sane, rational individual. The other one is that deranged animal that's involved in a dog collar situation with Dusty Rhodes. But he's a great tactician, Bob. We can't discount that ability.
Right, 100%. You can't take that away from him. He's got the mind that
when you put it into effect like that and in the planning stage, he can really come up with it. He knows wrestling inside out. He knows what a man can do, and he knows how to get a man to operate in the ring. I just happen to think that if you had an individual like Dr. Death Steve Williams in that varsity club, that would really be something devastating.
Well, it certainly would. I don't know. I'd have to dock it with and think about that long and hard. I don't think there's a lot of hope for Dr. Death to be in the varsity club, and that's my personal opinion.
No, we don't think he's the type of individual that would fit into that, Jim. It's just not his makeup.
Great drop kick there by Dr. Death. We know that he does possess all the skills that it takes to be a great professional athlete. There's that football tackle. The big man, now living in Shreveport, Louisiana, and of course, the NWA will be back in the Mid-South area in the not-too-distant future. We're talking about that in the hour. And here comes a stampede. The folks in Louisiana know this one quite well.
The shoulder in the midsection, the stampede. As the nightmare hits the bat and hits it hard, the count of three. And there you have the winner.
Dr. S.D. Williams. We'll take one more look at the Oklahoma stampede here. Bob Collins going to be talking with Dr. Death. And now here's Dr. Death with Bob Cottle.
All right, fans, we just saw him in action in the ring, and here is Dr. Death, Steve Williams, Kevin Sullivan, down here ringside taking notes, Steve. We know he's looking for another member of the varsity club. Are you that member?
It's like this, Bob. He's trying to be a scout, taking notes, because I'm that close of being a new world TV champion. Varsity Club before the Boss did, before John Elway did. I am the wrestling machine. And I'll tell you one thing, before it's all over with, I'll carry that belt and everybody in the world will be proud of me.
Dr. D.S.C. Williams, fans, when we come back, Bam Bam Bigelow in the ring right after this.
Welcome to the National Wrestling Alliance at 396 pounds from Asbury Park, New Jersey, with Sir Oliver Humperdinck, Bam Bam Bigelow.
And he was bizarre. Now you know what I mean. Look at the head. Look at those arms. Look at all those tattoos. Look at the size. Just look at the man.
396 pounds, and he can do things that are just simply amazing for a man his size. 396-pounder with Sir Oliver Humperdinck, and this big man is here. He means business in there with George South. Look at that agility.
The cartwheel right over South. And a drop kick. What about a man that big getting up for a drop kick?
That's a standing drop. Standing flat foot drop kick.
Big high back toss as South goes high to the air. Boy, he's a monstrous mountain of a man, but he has all of the agility and everything of a man about half that size.
Well, he is certainly one of the most physically intimidating athletes ever in professional wrestling, making his NWA debut right here on NWA Pro Wrestling. 396 pounds. You know he's bizarre. I mean, it's just not, you just don't see people walking around with a tattooed skull.
No.
He's as big and as bad as they come, and he will be, along with Sir Oliver Humperdinck, joining Jim Cornette. The Louisville Slugger segment coming up here in just a few moments in the program.
Man, that's where you got to get the mediums, sort of person to person, and you sure don't want to miss that. But in the ring right now, he's turned the mayhem loose on South. And South went right through the ropes. He came off, caught that foot flush in the face, through the ropes he went, off of the apron and out of the ring.
One thing about Big O that impresses me is his great flexibility. That kick to the face of George South is one indication of that. Big elbow. You've got to think, fans, everything he does, put it in perspective that he's a 396-pounder.
Look at that.
Karate kick to the back of the head. Hey, this man is a phenomenal athlete. I have never seen anybody this big that can move like he does, Bob, anywhere in wrestling.
No, and Jim, we've been around wrestling a long time. I've never seen, as you say, a man this size that can do that. What a move, a power move that's got to be.
Face first suplex. Impression. He is an impact player in the NWA, and he's here to crack some heads. That's his style. He is... Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jim Cornette and the Louisville Slugger.
Listen, I have, Bam Bam, Bigelow, nice to see you there. I'll talk about you in just a second, so don't get too antsy, okay? I've got to tell you, Humperdinck, you know, it has been so great to have you here on the show after watching you for so many, 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 many years. Ever since I was about 2 years old, you've managed champions. You've been friends of great people. You have rubbed elbows with all the movers and shakers in professional wrestling. You dress a little funny, but we're not going to get into that right now. And you...
Wait. First of all, let's clear the air and get a few things straight. I am not your dear personal friend. And your reference to many, many, many years, I know what you're talking about. But I want you to know something, Pally. I haven't changed in all those years you claim to know me. I haven't changed one little bit. I'm still a conniving, backstabbing individual I always was. And brother, don't ever say anything like that about me being your good friend, please.
Well, Humper, you know, it's just that I've always admired you, and I consider us friends, and I can see right now you haven't changed in all the many, many, many years that I've been watching you. You look the same as you always did, and I gotta say that that's very unique. But I gotta talk about Bam Bam Bigelow, the man. He's probably one of the most tremendous looking specimens of physicality I've ever seen in my life. He's a great bodyguard for you, a super bodyguard, and I gotta say that he's probably what?
You see, you got it all twisted around. There's some guys around professional wrestling, and you're one of them, that need bodyguards. This guy is no bodyguard. This is the beast from the east. And what we're doing here in the NWA is looking for every title and every belt that we can get our hands on. And by
okay, well, yeah. I had a bodyguard one time, too, but he got in that thing with Dusty Rhodes, and I've never seen him since, but Mama's going to give me another one. So Bam Bam would make a good bodyguard. Maybe I'll go where you got him. But even, he's not a bodyguard. He looks like he went to sleep with his head on the Sunday funnies, but he's a really big guy. But I'm going to say that. But, you know, I got a couple of champions, too, the World Tag Team Champions. It's the Midnight Express. We got the World Tag Team Championship belts, brother. We're proud of that.
To say this about that, I don't know to this day how you pull that off, Cornette, but it's true. You are the manager of the World Tag Team Champions. Well, let me tell you this.
Yeah, shut up.
We've got a partner in mind. Don't tell these people to shut up. We've got a partner in mind, And until the day that it's ready to be revealed, it will remain a secret. But I've got somebody in mind to team up with this man right here to go against your Midnight Express. And when that happens, you won't have no titles no more.
Now, wait a minute. You mean to tell me I invite you out here on my television show? I invite you out here. You bring this big fat slob in that funny outfit. And you, hey, this thing's over with. You can get the heck on out here. This whole show, this whole thing is over with. Hey, I'm not going to have you out here bad-mouthing me. And hey, come here, boy, come here. Yeah, what do you think about that, huh? What about you, Skullhead?
Let me tell you something. You and these two punks ain't gonna have them titles too long. And you, Cornette, you tell your mama, that you ain't safe. And you tell them Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East said so.
Get out of here, Rooster!
I got you pants are on fire.
I know. Let's get out of here. This is the end of the Louisville Slugger until next week. And as always, I'll be back, but they won't.
Assassins, one and two, to do battle with the Italian Stallion and Joe Cruz. And what a rough, tough combination Paul Jones has got here. These two have been just, they've been going right through everybody, Jim.
I've been very impressed with the progress of the Russian Assassins. And of course, when the United States Tag Team Tournament comes about in November, you can bet that this team will be right in the thick of things. But they're really right in the thick of things right now with the Coloss. And I'm talking plural, two of them.
That's right. We're talking about Nikita and Ivan Koloff, Jim. And they certainly are after what they have done to Ivan and also some things that they have done to Nikita.
Great rivalry here. And as a matter of fact, speaking to about the Koloffs, they're standing by. Let's go to them now.
There are two types of people in the world today. And Nikita, I appreciate you coming to my aid on several occasions. Assassins Paul Jones and you are all alike. Three of a kind. For what you have done to me in the past, you're going to have to answer to the Koloff family. You see, there are people that try to accomplish their goals without dignity. And you, Paul Jones, are the type that do not use any type of dignity. And for this, you are going to have to suffer. You are going to have to suffer in the worst way possible. Because you see, Paul Jones, I know that you are a treacherous man, that you will stoop to any level to accomplish your goals. And for this, Nikita and I, the Koloff family, are going to pay you back. You are not going to get away with your treacherous ways. You are a devious man, Paul Jones, and you and your assassins, yes, are going to have to answer to the Koloff family.
Reunited, a Koloff family and fans. You heard them there talking about Paul Jones and the Assassins. The Assassins, one and two, are really pounding and beating up on Joe Cruz right now.
Well, the Koloffs are no doubt as tough as they come, but they have a tremendous challenge ahead of them. The man is just tagging in at 6 feet eight, 330 pounds. They sent to the corner, and his partner, 6'4", 285, two big, massive, sadistic men that Paul Jones has got really running on all eight cylinders. And when they do meet the Koloss, you can bet, fans, that these four men from the Soviet Union will let it all out. It will be a very physical matchup. It'll be a very brutal match. You've got to think, Bob, not scientific whatsoever.
Oh, you're 100% right. And talking about Jones having him running on all of the cylinders, he has got them primed or in top shape, top condition. One of the favorite moves of the Russians right there.
That move right there made famous by Ivan Koloff himself. I'll tell you, what an hour it's been already. We've heard from Bam Bam Bigelow. We've seen Oliver Humperdinck. What a scary man he is. tag made. The Italian Stallion tag has been made.
Jim, talking about this hour, you know, since...
The referee didn't see it, and he loaded something in that head gear one more time. He's done it time and time again, and for what reason? For what reason? Look right there. There's the proof. There's the evidence right there, Bob. He loads the mask of the forehead.
And it's something that he doesn't need to do. They have the opponent beat, and he still loads the mask, and he still does it. We're certain he's loading it, even though... There's no way we can definitely prove. We see him put it in. We see him take it out.
That's the philosophy of Paul Jones. He says the man has the hardest head in wrestling. I imagine so. With a foreign object in there, the Russian assassins on a collision course with the Koloss, and fans will be back with more exciting action. Tony Schiavone will be with the United States heavyweight champion in just a few moments.
We are back with James J. Dillon and the U.S. Heavyweight Champion Barry Windham. And earlier we talked about the team of Lex Luger and Sting, the team that won the Crockett Cup back in April. But Ric Flair said it right when he said, you got the world champion and the U.S. champion, the two greatest wrestlers in the world right here.
You know, I'll tell you what, first of all, it was just a stroke of luck that those two won the Crockett Cup. Let me tell you what, Sting, anytime you stick your nose in a horseman's business, you're going to get stung. You know what I mean? Every time you've tried to interfere, you've been left laying in a little bit of your own blood. But let me tell you what, in any type of tag match where you bring Fatso Luger, the pumped up idiot, into the ring with you, and you think you're going to get something accomplished, you'd better think again, because it's not going to happen. Ric Flair, the ultimate wrestling machine, a professional wrestler, and Barry Windham, the United States Heavyweight Champion, are going to get it done. Because let me tell you, my ex-friend, I know how to deal with you, and it has never been more evident. You're crying over spilled milk because you cannot win this championship in every major arena across the country. I pinned you right on your back, and you've been crying all the way back to your dressing room while I've been out partying all night with Rick and James. So let me tell you, bring Luger in there, and the Nature Boy and I are going to teach you both a lesson that you're not going to forget, because the horsemen are going to do it their way, and you are not going to walk away victorious at all.
One thing for sure, Mr. Cornette is already feeling it. Every champion must face the test of time. Mr. Cornette was really squirming good today. And Sting and Luger, certainly winning the Crockett Cup was a tremendous honor. But that was a tournament that took place over two nights, and there's a lot of luck involved. But when you're the world heavyweight champion for almost 7 years, when you're the United States heavyweight champion for anywhere from a period of 6 months to a year on, it's not a fluke. That is the test of time. So Sting and Luger, bring your challenge forward. We're more than prepared, even though you are a great team.
All right, fans, let's go back to more action.
Bye-bye. All right, Tony, and back to the action, fans in the ring, and it's Dick Murdoch. As Murdoch here will take on David Eisley. And Jim Ross, I tell you, Murdoch is now back with a friend of his. And I tell you, things are beginning to move and move big in that way.
A lot of big things are happening, Bob. And, of course, next week, fans, in the last few weeks, Jim Crockett's been involved in some tremendous negotiation, no doubt about that. And with a true superstar, and this superstar, it looks like we'll be returning to the NWA. We hope to have it announced. We don't want to get the fans too excited about it. We'll talk about it next week, but it's going to knock the socks off.
That's right. Fans, since 1905, the NWA has been professional wrestling. And, Jim, as you say, next week that big announcement. But Murdoch, he's really trying to clean the plow of Eisley now. We talked about back with a former partner of his, close together, the man involved in some dog collar matches. And I tell you, pretty soon, the Mid-South area of the country is going to be seeing and hearing from them.
I know where he's going. I'm going to get up.
Watch out.
I knew that. The fans down around Shreveport, around Bourbon Street, Jackson, Mississippi, Baton Rouge, Little Rock, Arkansas, know this man, Captain Redneck, ever so well. If it ain't nailed down, it could be used as a weapon.
We That's right. That if you don't well. Have it nailed down or chained down, Murdoch is going to get it, and he's going to use it as he just did on Eisley. Talking about the Mid-South, Jim, an area that you know very well. You sort of cut your teeth in that part of the country. And I tell you, you got a lot of friends and a lot of family around that area. And I know they're going to be looking forward again to the NWA.
Latter part of this month, of course, the NWA back in great cities, the Ole Miss South, Little Rock, Arkansas, Greenwood and Jackson, Mississippi, Jackson, Tennessee. All great fans in that area. Baton Rouge, Louisiana, New Orleans, Alexandria. Just great wrestling fans. And we're going to be talking about that. I know, Bob, you're going to have a chance to talk to Dick Murdoch.
Right.
Maybe, because I know he's got great fans down there that he's really close to.
Murdoch really continuing to just pound Isley. Isley hasn't been able to get on track to do a thing. It's been Murdoch right on top of him and pounding him since the opening bell.
One of the great things about seeing Dick Murdoch back, and of course, Murdoch and I have never seen eye to eye as far as college football is concerned, but that's another point. The thing about seeing Dick Murdoch back is that Dusty Rhodes right now is challenging Gary Hart, Kevin Sullivan, Al Perez, Zabisco and company by himself in this dog collar situation. You can bet with old Captain Redneck around, there won't be any backstabbing, any bushwhacking, as they say out in West Texas around Canyon where he's from.
Murdoch now with Isley. He's going to get him up. Is it going to be the suplex? Holding him just at the point.
The brainbuster. Hey, he's had some battles with such athletes as the Funks, Killer Carl Cox, and many more in the Mid-South. Big Dick Murdoch is on his way back, fans. And he's going to be talking with Bob Caudle here in just a moment. And we're going to take another look at the brainbuster. This is patented Dick Murdoch, kick your fanny time. And he's going to be joined by the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. The Texas Outlaws are reuniting right here at ringside. And now let's go to Bob Caudle and a couple of legends.
All right, Jim, and thank you. You're right. I'm standing right between the two legends. Here they are, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Captain Redneck, Dick Murdoch. Dick, we've been talking about the Mid-South area, and that all of the friends of you and the Dream here going to be have a chance to see you back in the Mid-South pretty soon.
Well, let's go one thing quick, Bob Caudle. You know, Psycho Herbert Coleman of Canyon, Texas said, when Dusty Rhodes and Dick Murdoch back together, the original Texas Outlaws, there is not a tag team combination safe in the world today. And we are going to make a swing through the Mid-South. I'm talking about Little Rock, Baton Rouge, Greenwood, New Orleans, Pat O'Brien's and Bourbon Street. And some of the greatest wrestling fans in the world are down there. There's been a lot of history made in that part of the United States. And I'll guarantee you what, Gary Hart, Kevin Sullivan, Al Perez, and the rest of you, in those dog-collar matches or whether it's tag team combinations, Dick Murdoch is going to be right there along with Dusty Rhodes. I'll guarantee you what, there's going to be pandemonium and mayhem break loose, and we are going to be chaos and part of it.
Well, I know you're ready, Dusty, now.
Well, I'm telling you what, I'm ready all the time. Live and in color, Dick Murdoch laid it on the line. When the Texas Outlaws came back together, there was nothing safe. There was not a man, woman, a child on the face of the earth safe. Now then, the Midnight Express. When I do with this dog collar situation, let me tell you something, baby. If you still got them world tag team titles around your waist, me and the captain are going to take them from you, baby. We go and oh, my Lord, did you see Mr. Bigelow, the beast from the east out here, telling Jim Cornette about his mama? Woo! About your mama, baby. You better look out. You better watch out. Because now then, the National Wrestling Alliance becomes awesome in the fall of 1988. And yes, 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 yes. Kevin Sullivan, dog collar around your neck, a dog collar around my neck, and the baddest dog of them all watching my back, Jack. And that's when it's funky like a monkey.
All right, there you have it, fans. The American Dream, Captain Redneck, Dick Murdoch, Larry Zbysko, Al Perez in tag team action when we come back right after this. All right, fans, in the center of the ring, Mr. Gary Hart, and a man who has got it all, athletically speaking, Al Perez, just a tremendous athlete. A man who has got a lot of wrestling ability and knowledge in that body, but he's got so much agility, so much really just athletic ability to go along with it, that he is really something to watch in the ring.
When he walks in the ring with Gary Hart, it's almost like Beauty and the Beast. You wonder, what could he have in common? Whatsoever could this handsome young man, this great athletic background, great high school athlete. He's excelled in three or four sports. What does he have in common with Gary Hart?
I think I can give you that in one word, Jim. That's got to be money.
I guess so.
Money, absolutely right.
I'll tell you what, it's been a very enlightening hour, Bob. We know now the Stinger, of course, have gotten involved in Ric Flair's business, and now we can see some great tag team events with Sting and Luger versus Flair and Windham. That was what a combination for the big stars in wrestling, hooking up in one ring at one time. The fans getting a big treat out of that.
Well, we talked about Larry Zbysko and Al Perez. You talk about all of those, and I'm sure now that all of those teams are looking toward that U.S. Tag Team Tournament and that vacated title and that tournament, which is going to be coming up in October, Jim.
Al Perez sends Trent Knight outside. You're right, Bob. As a matter of fact, that tournament will be coming up in November.
Right.
Fans can be looking forward to that. It's about a month to get that all organized. Right here, Al Perez is certainly disorganizing the senses of Trent Knight here. And this young man, what a phenomenal athlete. And he, too, would like to prove himself against the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. There's the Gary Hart.
Now, Hart with a victory cigar. He's got that big victory cigar. Already got it lit, already smoking it. Perez again out of the ring to get Knight. Slam him to the concrete floor. He begins to just punish the opponent. That, I think, is indicative of what Gary Hart does. Hart, in just about any match that you see his man in, it's like he always wants to send somebody a message.
Well, I'm sure Hart's not too pleased that Dick Murdoch's back on the scene. Murdoch will be at ringside when Dusty Rhodes takes on Hart's people in these dog collar showdowns, whether it's a Kevin Sullivan or an Al Perez or Larry Zbysko, for that matter. Whomever it may be, it's irrelevant. Dick Murdoch is going to stand by his friend.
Well, they're not going to have Dusty Rhodes out there all by himself. Rhodes is going to have somebody to sort of watch his back and to give him a hand when he needs it. Now Perez, he's got Trent on his shoulders. Jim, this could be it. There he goes with an airplane spin.
As I have said before, this is his signature maneuver. This move is 100% Al Perez. Perez modified airplane spin. It's like a human frisbee flying through the air, nowhere to go but down, right on your back on the canvas. Perez is in such magnificent condition. He is a real thoroughbred. Hart has met a great find when he signed this kid.
No doubt about it. And he goes with that airplane spin, and then he just launches his opponent right out of that, as he did just...
I'm sure Hart gave him a real lucrative contract. Don't you know, Gary Hart being so fair? Right back up there he is one more time.
Can a man take two of them? Knight's going to have to. Watch out.
Perez applied it two times. He's in the ropes. Hart telling him to give him the spinning toe, make him suffer. You can hear it right there, Bob.
Right, says make him suffer. He's already had him suffering from those airplane spins. Now with that spinning toe, look at him put the pressure on, and then he backs off of it.
Two of the greatest NWA champions of all time, Dory Funk Jr. and Terry Funk. That maneuver right there took them to the championship. I wonder if it can take this man to a major championship. Look at him, deep, he's got it locked in. Nice, those ligaments really stretched there. This is a phenomenal wrestler. With or without Gary Hart around, don't discount that. That kid is a winner.
Gary Hart, Al Perez, you just saw this phenomenal athlete in action in the ring. By the way, vacated tag team title tournament coming up very soon. Now we got Dusty Rhodes and Dick Murdoch back together. What about that? Must give you a little bit of uneasiness there, Gary.
I have, as you well know, Larry Zbysko, a champion in his own right, a Western Heritage heavyweight champion, and Al Perez in this very same tournament. Dickie Murdoch, Dusty Rhodes. I'm also hearing rumors that Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East, has bringing a partner into this area for that. But let me tell you something. When you can put together two wrestlers such as Larry Zbysko and Al Perez. Now, Murdoch and Rhodes, you're barroom brawlers. You're real big and real tough. When you take somebody outside and you pick up a chair or a table and you lay it across their head, because that's how you grew up. That's how you fight. The Beast from the East, I'm sure he hung around Brooklyn, Bedford Stuyvesant. I'm sure you know how to fight too. I know very well that Sir Oliver Humperdinck ain't never touched nothing but a diamond. But remember, we're talking about the wrestling business. Everybody knows Larry Zbysko's capabilities. He is a veteran of many ring wars. Al Perez is the greatest of all the young lions to come along. You and Jim Ross cannot find enough adjectives to describe his ability. And who can say there is anybody that has more success managing wrestlers and leading them to the top other than Gary Hart? You deny it, Rhodes. You deny it, Murdoch. Beast of the East. And Sir Oliver Humperdinck, deny it. Who's going to be the next United States Tag Team Champions?
Well, you know, when you talk about wrestling, you talk about the sport. Larry Zbyszko and myself have all the talent it takes to be U.S. Tag Team Champs.
And see you next week. And until then, so long for now.